is probably the favourite here, just in front of El Guerrouj. And Kiptanui Lefas Estevez has been in so many finals against El Guerrouj. The second Moroccan Kayush, Windamu, the young Ethiopian, Silva, East, Bulafane, and Heshko. Lagat's been in great form. Both Lagat and El Guerrouj have broken 3:30 on two occasions this year. He's had this remarkable record, El Guerrouj. He's won 84 out of his last 89 races. But two of those five defeats were in Olympic finals, and two of those five defeats have come in the last 6 weeks. So he lost three races in 8 years, two in 6 weeks. I think globally it's fair to say that this is the most anticipated track race here in Athens.
Look, I think you're right. And there are so many questions here. What will the Kenyans do? Will they run as a team? What will El Guerrouj do? And his countryman, Kayush, will he pace him? Can Lagat out-sprint him in the straight like he did in Zurich?
Just saw Lagat, and we just saw Kiptanui. Here's Lefas, and before them, El Guerrouj. Lefas, the top Dutch, 1.576. Estevez, he's shaved his head tonight. There's the Moroccan Kayush, who has paced before, says he won't tonight. The young Ethiopian, Windamu. Rui Silva, like Estevez, in a lot of those finals. Michael East has a lot of ability. The Brits have a wonderful tradition in this race. Bulafane, Morsali won for Algeria. And Heshko, third last year in the world titles. 2-3-4-8. Here's Lagat. He's the favourite Kenyan. He and El Guerrouj are the only two men ever to break 3:27. He's the second fastest man ever. He was third in Sydney behind Nien, with El Guerrouj second. And there he is. They embraced earlier. El Guerrouj went around and shook everybody's hand. So will he be successful and then arguably the best ever? Or will he be the best never to win the 1500? Almost retired after Sydney. So broken was he. But his training partner talked him back into it. He then went on a winning spree again. Suffered from chest infection this year. Looked as if he mightn't get here in one stage, but he's been able to regroup. But he and Lagat had a epic race in Zurich, and Lagat just got the better of him. 2.481 Kayush. He made the pace for El Guerrouj and Seville in the final of the World Championships. You just feel it's going to be quick tonight. It's a classic race, isn't it? The 1500, the metric mile. They've showcased it here. They put it on very late at night. They've made sure it's the last race. Gee, 4 minutes can make a big difference in a person's life. Kenyans with their heads down. Song got closest to us. Still they wait. They've been out there a long time. Up they come, they toe the line. El Guerrouj's fate decided in the next 4 minutes. Songok, Toei, away. El Guerrouj, in fact, a false start. Songok looked as if on the inside he might have had his foot over the line. Well, what an anti-climax here.
Well, not really, we just build it up even more. Have a look. The foot on the inside, Songok, he wants to go. Come on, let's get on with it. And the starter's pulled it up, and look, it probably didn't make much difference at all, but what it does do is mean that Hicham El Guerrouj has a couple more minutes to contemplate whether he can carry the burden of his Olympic misery over the last 8 years through this race. And the people that saw him underneath the stand in 2000 after he was beaten said they haven't seen anything that's sadder than that in sport. He was just sobbing for half an hour after being defeated in 2000.
So can he turn it into tears of joy tonight? Inconsolable in Sydney. He was the hottest of favourites there. But tonight, the bookies might have him favourite, but Lagat should be. So for the second time. Away, and El Guerrouj tucks in. Songok out quickly. Kiptanui looked across. Lagat. El Guerrouj a long way out back. He comes off the rail. Songok leads. Estevez, Heshko, Kiptanui. And El Guerrouj moving around. Lagat up in front of him early. El Guerrouj working hard early. He He's around the outside, and now they jam up. Will he go right round them and go to the front? At the moment, he doesn't. Windermere's outside Sogot. El Guerrouj is about five wide here. He's very wide as they slow right up. Laggett's on the inside, and El Guerrouj is content. He's hanging about now. Kayush behind him. So they've slowed up. Laggett in the centre, Kiptanui, and then Songok. And they've got El Guerrouj wide with Windermere in front of him and Heskew on his inside.
Well, 3:44 is the pace at the moment. And one of our questions has been answered. Kayush is not doing the pacemaking at the moment for El Guerrouj, and the Kenyans are running together. And that's no surprise.
Songok leads. So they've done a lap in 60 seconds. That's pedestrian, all right. Kiptanui, Laggett, Windermere, El Guerrouj fifth. Here comes Estevez, the big Spaniard. So Laggett, the favourite, gets through on the inside. They leave some room for him, the Kenyans. And again, he goes through and drives through on Kiptanui. El Guerrouj, good move. Very good move. Now he needs some breathing space. He wants to put Laggett in a pocket here, I think. Estevez hasn't quite done the job. It's slow, so the wide running of El Guerrouj at this stage won't be hurting him. Laggett on the inside. Estevez the centre. And then El Guerrouj. Songot, Heskio, Windermere, Leifers, Bullafane. Now El Guerrouj. Now the best bet for him is to wind it up from about 700. The race is about to start. He's got the confidence to go to the front. Leads Laggett. Estevez, Windermere, Heskio, Bullafane. The other Kenyans are out the back suddenly.
Well, this is a situation that Hicham El Guerrouj knows. It's what he did in Sydney, and what he's done every time he's broken a world record. And the pace is still pretty comfortable. So for Hicham El Guerrouj, he just wants to stroll around at this pace and continually wind it up from once he gets into the straight and then go for home once he gets into the last 200.
So Laggett's on his own now. The Kenyans, I don't think, can help him. El Guerrouj from the front. Laggett, Windermere, the teenager from Ethiopia. The best of Africa. Morocco, Kenya, Ethiopia. Heskio, Estevez, Bullafane. And then Kiptanui. One more lap to go in the final of the 1500. It's what we dreamed about. The Moroccan and the Kenyan. And wind it up he does. He's just off the rail, isn't he? Just off the plinth. 300 out. Laggett sits. Heskio's third. And then Estevez. And Silva's running on behind them. El Guerrouj leads by a metre. Laggett's close. Heskio and then Silva. Kenny, hang on. Laggett to attack. Does Hicham have one last kick? Can he go from champion to legend? Or has Laggett got him? Or could Silva kick both of them? El Guerrouj tackle. Laggett goes up and takes the lead. El Guerrouj can't quite hold him. Laggett's in front, but he's coming back, the champ. El Guerrouj is coming back. He is a legend. How sweet it is. He goes from the greatest never to the best of all time. It was the most famous victory imaginable. The way that he fought on and got rid of his demons in 50 metres. Silver for the place. So his destiny is fulfilled. Tears again tonight, but they're different from Sydney.
What a race. What a run. What a run. To come, he looked gone. He looked gone at 200. Laggett looked comfortable. He looked gone for all money. At 80 metres to go, exactly what happened in Zurich. He came back. And he has confirmed his spot at the very top of this event. Rui Silva celebrates his bronze medal. Laggett ran a great race. I'm sure this wasn't the case, but coming down the straight, you just sense that Laggett didn't have the heart to allow Al Guerrouj to lose. I'm sure that's not right, but it just looked like that for a second. And this man, what a fantastic career he's now had.
Well, he was a lion tonight. He showed all the fighting qualities that we hoped he had and weren't sure that were there at his greatest moment. He looked it in the eye tonight and responded in the way that I think we've all hoped that he would. Sometimes classics don't quite live up to their names and their build-up. I think in the men's 200-meter freestyle, we saw it here with Thorpe and Phelps and Hackett and Vandenhoogenband. And tonight we have seen the classic 1500 go right down to the wire. Here, he's not going to win. And yet, he finds that little bit of something that will change his life forever. He now is fulfilled completely as an athlete. Such a fine line between the exhilaration of winning and the despair of finishing.